In my own personal Bible reading plan, today brought me to Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. In the heart of it all, he addresses the subject of worry. He gave some practical advice about how to deal with it. First and foremost, you must recognize that the Lord is your provider, and he knows what you need even before you do. Jesus referred to the Lord's care for the birds of the air and the flowers of the field, and then he said, if he cares for them, he will certainly care for you. That doesn't mean you won't face difficulties. It means that you can trust the Lord to be there when they come. As Jesus said, each day has enough trouble of its own. So don't borrow tomorrow's trouble today. Corrie ten Boom said, worry doesn't empty tomorrow of its sorrow. It empties today of its strength. So ask yourself this, do I really trust God with my future? Many of us say we do, and then we spend our time in futility focused on things over which we have no control. You may have heard that famous statistic, 97% of what you worry about never happens. And I know there are some of you who respond by saying, yes, I know, but I still worry about the 3%. When you give your future to the Lord, it frees you to live today. Irma Bombeck said, worry is like a rocking chair. It gives you something to do, but it doesn't get you anywhere. Jesus reminded us that worry is a matter of priorities, and it gets our priorities out of whack. It was in his discussion about this subject that he gave this famous advice. Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things, the things God knows you need, will be given to you as well. Regarding priorities, I've often said, whatever you make most important in your life sits on the throne of your heart, and everything else bows to it. In this context, Haddon Robinson wrote, what worries you masters you. And worry is indeed a cruel taskmaster. It steals your joy today and saps your spiritual, emotional, and physical energy. As has often been said, one day of worry is harder than a week of work. These days provide an excellent proving ground for you to work on readjusting your priorities. Lay worry aside. It might be just as simple as Bobby McFerrin sang back in the 1980s. Don't worry, be happy.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now.